Father, we just thank you for this this morning, Father, as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord, for a wonderful time to do that. We thank you for the special opportunity it is, Father, just to honor you and to remember that this is the day that Christ is risen. He's risen indeed, Father. We thank you, Lord, for everyone that came out this morning. I pray that you would bless this time together, Father, as we honor you and we love the Lord Jesus. Father, we pray these things in his name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jordan.
I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I need him,
always near. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart.
Drive the nails in my hands, laugh at me where you stand. Go ahead and say it isn't me. The day will come when you will see. Cause I'll rise again. There's no power on earth can tie me down. Yes, I'll rise again. Death can't keep off my name. My love for you is still the same. Go ahead and bury me, but very soon I will be free. See you. but all will see that I'm the one, 'cause I'll come again. There's no power on earth can keep me back. Yes, I'll
singing.
People said I never make it. They said I never see it through. They don't know what keeps me going. I guess they never have met you. In shambles until the day you came along. You turned my tears into laughter. Lord, I'm still holding on. I'm still holding on. Lord, I'll never let you go. You gave me a smile. You took touch my heart, you touch my soul. And all those bridges left behind me, Lord, I burn them to the ground. I'm still holding on to the best friend I've ever found. Voted likely not to prosper. Left hanging over my head. Said you'll never count for nothing. That's what most people have said. I'm still holding on. Lord, I'll never let you go. You gave me a smile. You touched my heart, you touched my soul. And all those bridges left behind me, Lord, I burn them to the ground. I'm still holding on. Lord, you're the best friend I've ever found. And all those bridges left behind me, Lord, I burn them to the ground. No, I'm still holding on. You're the best friend I've ever found.
Amen.
Church for giving me the opportunity to bring a short message this morning. Many years ago, when I started doing public speaking, it was in the workplace, and I learned a valuable, valuable lesson. And that was to speak using the 3B method. Be sincere, be short, and be simple. So I don't have a 45-minute sermon. But you know, we gathered today at a time of day that is special to us, the sunrise. And God created sunrises. And the way he did it, as the sun begins to pop up on the eastern horizon, which we know is really not popping up, it's not really rising, the earth is rotating, but that really doesn't matter. But all the moisture and the particulates, airborne particulates, disperses the white light of the sun and gives us colors orange to red and everything in between. It's just gorgeous. But there's other reasons we like it. Each sunrise signals the start of a new day. And that brings along with it promises of good things to happen. Yesterday's gone. We got a chance for a new day, a new start. And that may be why that states like Minnesota, Alaska, Florida, Virginia, West Virginia, you find hometowns named sunrise. Because it has a special meaning to us. They hold a lot of meaning. It's a fresh start, a new day. It brings with it optimism. We got a chance for new good things to happen to us in this day all the mistakes of yesterday are over. We can learn from them as we move forward. Now, of all the sunrises that happened since the very first one, I can't imagine any morning being greater than the third day after Jesus' death.
That's right, amen.
Friday brought denial, trial, pain, and death. Saturday, many were filled with hopelessness. But then came the sunrise on the third day. And that's spelled S-U-N-R-I-S-E. But on that day, we had a very special sunrise.
That's right.
S-O-N-R-I-S-E. Mark 16 tells us, when the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on the way to the tomb, and they asked each other, who will roll the stone away from the entrance? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled away. And as they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in white sitting on the right side, and they were afraid. Don't be alarmed, he said. You are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He has risen.
Amen.
He is not here. See the place where they laid him. We find on that Easter morning, that miracle, like every morning is a miracle, but we find the miracle of the sunrise, the rise of the Son of God. You see, Christ, he didn't stay dead once he was offered himself on the cross. He paid for the sin, our sins, on the cross. Then he rose from the dead and conquered death. With his resurrection, his mission and life purpose was complete. So the sunrise of Easter brings with it so much promise, just as every day does. It gives us such hope for a fresh start and a new chance at life. The sunrise of Easter gives us reason for optimism, that we have something to live for in life, and strength to face each other. The sunrise of Easter promises us brand new life and a change on the inside more than we ever could have imagined without Christ. Fresh start, John 3, 14 through 17 says, just as Moses lifted up the snake in the desert, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Optimism. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through him. New life. 2 Corinthians 5, 14 through 17 says, for Christ's love compels us. Because we are convinced that one died for all, and therefore all died. And he died for all, that those who should live should no longer live for themselves, but for him who died for them and was raised again. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creature. A new creature. On that sunrise service, we read the Mark's rendition of it. Matthew adds a little bit to it. Said in verse 5 of the 28th chapter of the book, Matthew says, the angel said to the women, do not be afraid. I know you're looking for Jesus who was crucified. He's not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you to Galilee. 3 points here. First of all, we don't need to be afraid of anything. The message of the angel gave to the ladies is the basic need of the human heart. We fear. But with God, there is no fear. We have no need to fear. Second, we need to be aware. These ladies had been there when they put Christ on the cross. They watched him die. They were there when they took the body down. They were there when they prepared it to put it in the tomb. They were there when they closed it up. They came back on that morning to find him gone. We need to be aware that he is alive.
That's right.
Just as they were.
Amen.
The angel was quick to point out that Jesus had told them that he would come back alive. But we just didn't, they didn't understand. Hopefully, everyone here this morning does understand that. That he's alive and we have hope for eternal salvation.
Amen.
The truth of the resurrection is the core of what we believe as Christians. Without the resurrection, there is no eternal life. Without the resurrection, there's no hope. Without the resurrection, there's no forgiveness.
That's right.
Of our sins. The third point is we need to be active. The angel said, come and see, then go and tell.
Yes.
And we need to be about the going and telling.
Amen.
Our Father and our God, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for what this day means for mankind, for us as your servants. God, we just praise your name that you've loved us that much to send your son to die a horrible, horrible death because of my sins. God, we know people around us that don't know you. Give us the courage, give us the words to say so that we too can go and tell about the love of your son. We ask these things in your precious name. Amen.
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 All right.
Thank you.
45 minutes.